This is the SRT Red Line Mass Transit System, and it is a mega 139.3-kilometer railway system serving Thailand's key destination, the Bangkok Metropolitan Region. This massive transportation plan is estimated to cost a whopping 340 billion baht, making it one of the most ambitious projects of the country. This extensive SRT rail system is composed of two distinct lines, specifically called the Dark Red Line and Light Red Line. The Dark Red Line is an 86.8-kilometer long rail system spread starting from Rangsit all the way to Maha Chai. Total of 37 stations to accommodate this rapid line. The Light Red Line is a 58.5-kilometer long rail system stretching from Huamak, passing through Bangsu and reaching Talingchan, which will also be extended to 20 stations in different destinations. The rolling stock that would be used for the SRT Red Line mass transit plan is constructed by a Japanese company called Hitachi. There will be a total of 25 EMU sets of rolling stock accompanied by 130 cars, which will be traveled by over 300,000 passengers every single day and continue to increase as expansions go on. The operating speed is around 120 kilometers per hour, but its maximum speed can go as much as 160 kilometers per hour. In further detail, the Light Red Line was first constructed way back in 2010 and had finished its line in 2012 from Bangsu to Talingchan. Throughout its few years of operation until 2014, it had both been limited in train operations and daily passenger flow, and because of this, it was suspended. The reasons it was stopped varies, both economically and making ways for better lines. Years have gone by since then, and the rise of Thailand's population and economy has sparked a need for the reopening of the line to accommodate the current and upcoming community that is to come. The Light Red Line is constructed in five phases, the first of which was the Bangsu-Talingchan, is a 15-kilometer length that is, as of the time of this writing, is in trial operation and is expected to open its commercial use by the 1st of November. The second phase runs from Talingchan to Salaya, and the third phase from Talingchan to Surash, which are 12 and 6.5 kilometers respectively. The long-term extension that willfully makes this transit system an ambitious long-term plan is the Bangsu to Huamak and Salaya to Nakhon Pathom, which are 25 and 30 kilometers respectively. The Dark Red Line, on the other hand, was also a plan way back in 2009. By that time, everything was also secured, the loans, equipment, and companies. However, the project was rather delayed because of several problems, from its budget to its design. As soon as everything has been done, its construction had finally started in 2013 and was scheduled for completion by 2016. But as they found themselves through the project, they had seen both the need for a better design and more tracks, and thus pushed the project further. Even though it has seen several delays, it had actually driven the project to become better, from which it first started as just a 24 billion baht to over 88 billion baht railway mega project. As of 2021, this project's first 26 kilometers from Rangsit to Bangsu is now on track to head to its commercial use by the 1st of November, along with the Light Red Line. Its total line length is over 86.8 kilometers. The first 26 is from the first phase, and the next other phases are from the Thammasat University to Rangsit, Bangsu to Hua Lamphong, and from Hua Lamphong to Bangbon, of which will be a total of 47 kilometers. Several other phases are expected but are still in the planning phases. In total, the Red Line will be a huge 139.3-kilometer system, and according to the State Railway of Thailand, they are targeting to finish all of its phases by 2025, meaning that they are fast-forwarding the construction of this project. This way, the city of Bangkok will be enabled to have a better, safer, and more efficient transportation system. Considering it houses over 10 million people, the need for a more viable option is such a necessity, meaning that this project is economically, socially, and environmentally good. Environmentally, because of how it may replace several bus lines and people who drive their vehicles. Once the SRT Red Line has finished its full project, this will not just enable an easier way to travel, but will also increase the flow of international traffic. Knowing that Thailand is a key destination for tourists to come, this project will yet again help accommodate that flow of traffic to the country. With people coming in from various parts of the world, this will also help increase the prices of real estate, goods, and services, and ultimately benefit the country and its people. Anyway, what do you think about the SRT Red Lines? Share with us your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to leave us a like and follow us for more amazing videos. Thanks for watching.